Hi everyone, in this tutorial, we will create a swiper slider with CSS animations. The text and image will appear with smooth effects. The frame will be designed using the clip path property. It will also fill with color when the slide becomes active. The design is fully responsive and works well on different screen sizes. Let's get started. Let's begin with the HTML. First, we add the CDN links to include swiper's functionality. Now we create the basic swiper layout. This slider has navigation bullets. Each slide has two main parts, a text section and an image section. The text section has a title and a short description. Each title has a different color. The image section has a frame and an image. Each frame has a different color using a data attribute. There are four slides, but you can add fewer or more if you want. We use images with a transparent background. Now let's move on to the CSS. In this part, we will style the text, images, and frame. We also create smooth animations for them. We use these fonts for the title and description. We set a variable for the image size. The body has a background image that covers the full screen. You can find the image link in the description so you can download it if you'd like. Each slide is set to a grid layout with two columns, one for the text and one for the image. It takes up 100% of the viewport height. We center the text and add padding from the left. Each title has a different color. This is set with the data color attribute. The title and description animate when the slide becomes active. They fade in and move down using keyframes. We use Flexbox to center the image. We also set the margin to center the image wrapper. We create the frame using a clip path property. You can find this property in the description. We set the Z index of the frame to 2. This way, the backpack image will be behind the frame. The frame color fills starting from the top right. Each frame has a different border and background color. The image is half the size of the frame, so it looks smaller. We apply a shadow effect to each image. This makes the images look more dimensional. We also set the Z index to 1 so the image stays behind the frame. When the slide is active, the image moves up and fades in. These navigation bullets are customized to be bigger and rounded. The active bullet becomes longer and changes color. Now we add media queries to make the design responsive. The image wrapper width is reduced. We also reduce the left padding of the text for smaller screens. The layout changes to vertical on smaller screens. We set the positions of the image and text using the grid template areas property. Now we hide all elements to prepare them for animation. The title is hidden with an opacity of 0. We do the same for the description. We set the frame's width and height to 0 to remove its color at first. We add a color transition animation to the active slide. The image is also hidden to be revealed later. Now let's move on to JavaScript. In this part, we set up the swiper slider with effects and controls. We use the fade effect to make the slides fade in and out. We make the pagination bullets clickable. We enable mousewheel control to scroll through the slides. The keyboard arrows can also be used to change slides. And there you have it. We created a responsive swiper slider with CSS animations. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.